Welcome into the special for the David Hookstead Show College Football Championship Weekend, Conference Championship Weekend, I should say, not the overall Conference Championship Weekend, obviously. That is not until January, but the regular season is over. It's crazy to say. I mean, it's just nuts to think about. I mean, here we are. It's a fine day in America. It's what, the fourth? I always forget this stuff. The fourth, Saturday, the fourth. I cannot believe this season is over. The regular season is over. I mean, it feels like just yesterday, I was arguing with my friends in August about preseason rankings, Heisman odds, national title odds. And now here we are, Conference Championship Day weekend. We have so many great games. We're going to get into those in a little bit. We're going to do some previews and my picks. But before we get into that, I just want to say a big thank you to all of you who took this journey with us this year. I want to say a huge thank you to everyone that has been a part of this show since we started doing the college football stuff, since college football started. The numbers on it have been huge. You guys are all the reason for that. It has very little to do with me, actually. It has virtually everything to do with you, the listener. You guys are enjoying it. You're coming in. You're spending time here. You're interacting with me. You're roasting me when the Badgers lose. You're arguing with me when the Badgers would win. We're going back and forth. And it's created really probably the most fun experience I've had in my 6+ years doing this. So again, I can't thank you all enough. You're such a big part of it. And I hope you guys have had as much fun as I have, because I've had a ton of fun. All right, let's get into a couple stories I want to get into. Number one, before we get into the game previews, everyone's talking about Brian Kelly, Lincoln Riley, and who's going to be more successful overall, who's going to be more successful first. Listen, Brian Kelly's going to be more successful first, and the reason why is very simple. LSU just has more talent than USC does, okay? They just have more talent. They're better positioned today to be a winning program. You know, Coach O, even though he failed to win, he brought in a lot of great players, brought in a lot of high-caliber players. The team is loaded with talent, loaded with star potential. Brian Kelly's going to have more success right away than Lincoln Riley will. But Lincoln Riley, if he can lock down the California recruiting, lock down the West Coast recruiting, because they play in the Pac-12, which is such a weak conference overall, Lincoln Riley's upside is huge. Lincoln Riley's upside when it comes to winning is substantially larger, I would say, than what Brian Kelly's is. In fact, I would say it's a lot bigger. His ability, remember, he's going to be playing trash teams more times than not. So if he goes 12-0, 11-1, whatever it might be, he's going to be in the playoff every year, contending for a national title every year. If he can get USC to that point, which I think he will, because I think he'll do really well recruiting. He obviously is an offensive genius. They know how to pass the ball. They know how to run the ball. Look at the quarterbacks who played for him in the past. I mean, even Spencer Rattler, even though he got benched, superstar recruit, great player. Caleb Williams, number one QB recruit, I believe, at his a dual threat in the country. So he's going to have a lot of success. And so when you look in 5 years, who's going to be better positioned? USC being in the Pac-12 is just better off, because it's an easier conference. That's just a fact. That's just the reality of the situation. So I would say Lincoln Riley will be more successful long-term. Brian Kelly in the first year or two, maybe even by year three, will have more success. By year five or six, you're going to see Lincoln Riley is going to be in a much better position, in my humble opinion. All right, let's get into some game previews. There's two games that I really want to preview before we get into the picks. First and foremost, Georgia and Alabama, okay? Everyone has crowned Georgia national champs already, right? No one is giving Alabama the time of day. No one thinks if Michigan gets in, they can win. Obviously, no one thinks Cincy can win. Everyone thinks Alabama is going to roll to the national title. Georgia's going to roll the national title. Might have been a little Freudian slip for me there. Listen, anyone who thinks Georgia's going to blow out Alabama, as long as Nick Saban's alive and walking on the sidelines, is a fool. That's foolish behavior. That's a foolish take. Now, I expect and I would bet what the odds are is that Georgia wins this game. This is not going to be a blowout. This is not going to be close to a blowout, my friends. Not at all. Okay? Georgia might win. Georgia ain't running Alabama off the field anywhere. Nobody's running Alabama off the field. That's a fact. So I think anyone who thinks Georgia's going to come in and kick Nick Saban's ass is fooling themselves. Now, again, they might win. They're favored to win. That's the other thing. Everyone's talking about how Alabama's going to get like exposed in this game. How do you get exposed in a game when you're the underdog? If anything, the only thing that can get exposed here is Georgia. So I fully expect Alabama to keep this tight, keep it close. I'll give you my actual pick when we get to the gambling picks. Next, Michigan-Iowa. Michigan is fighting for their greatest season in I don't even know how long. Decades, right? Decades since they've been this good, this close to a national title, because if they win, they're in. Look, Iowa's not a good offensive team. They got a solid defense, but they have problems on the field. I think Michigan likely dominates this game. I don't know if they win by double digits because, again, it's a Big Ten title game. Fans are going to be amped up. Everyone's going to be excited. It's hard to blow teams out in conference title games. Now, I recognize the absurdity of a guy like me saying that who's a Wisconsin fan when I believe it was 2014. Was it 2014 when we lost 59-0 to Ohio State? Was that 2014, 2015? I was sitting, okay, well, let's take a little walk down memory lane. This is a true story. I'm not going to say the names of the other people involved because I, you know, they've gone on to have very successful careers. We don't want to air out where the dirty bodies, where the dead bodies might be. I was sitting at a bar in Madison, Wisconsin called Church Key. I actually went and revisited it when I was in Wisconsin for a wedding that not that long ago. I was sitting there with my buddy, a couple buddies, one of whom I was really, really, really close with. And they used to have these big glass cups, right, where you could drink out of them. And for $20, they would fill this thing up. It was the equivalent of like 2.5 pitchers. We knew the guy who was the manager, so he'd cut us a slick deal. And anyways, I remember sitting there drinking, watching Ohio State kick our ass, even though we had Melvin Gordon. I just couldn't believe it. I was stunned by the fact that, Cardale Jones, the third stringer, lit us up like a Christmas tree. So I understand the absurdity of saying you don't get blown out in conference title games coming from me. But I don't see Michigan blowing Iowa out. I think Iowa comes in amped up, ready to play. They can still play for the Rose Bowl. But I do think Michigan wins. So let's get into the picks. All right, I like Oklahoma State -5.5 against Baylor. I think that their defense is just too good, too dominant. I don't see anything about Baylor that convinces me that they're gonna keep this game, that they're going to win. I like Alabama +6.5. Call me crazy. I would not take Alabama on the money line. I'm not that confident. I do like them on the 6.5. Cincy, Houston. Give me Houston 10.5. It's just double day. Again, you don't blow teams out generally in conference title games. Houston is not a bad team. I don't think they're going to get crushed. I do expect Cincy to win. I think it's closer than double digits. And give me Iowa +11. Same thing. I don't see Michigan running this up. I think it'll be a great game. Anyways, that's all we got for the conference championship preview of the David Hookstead Show. I am about to run out here, meet up with some friends at the bar. We're going to catch the early games, and the Badgers play Marquette. I'm really excited about that. Anyways, do yourselves all a favor. Have yourselves a great Saturday. Go crush it. Go drink some beers. We're in for an awesome Saturday at college football.